Like I said, my name is Willie Collins. I'm a pastor. I'm originally from Sarasota.
Okay.
We pastor a church. Our church is called Living Faith Fellowship Church in San Antonio, Texas. My wife and I, we pastor a church there. And right now, my buddy here, Pastor Trey, we have, like I said before, we have a YouTube channel called Bros for Real. So we go around and engage people all around the world, all walks of life, rather if they know and love Jesus or not. But we were
in Jesus.
amen. So we were intrigued by your sign, and we just want to ask you, what motivated you to be out here doing what you're doing right in front of Planned Parenthood, because we are pro-life, and but what motivated you to be out here today?
Well, what motivated me is God called me to do this. He called me to make a stand for the most innocent of human beings, which is the child in the mother's womb.
Right.
And there is nothing more innocent than that. He tells us to defend the taking of life. He hates the taking of innocent life.
Right.
And so that motivates me, and I've been doing it since 1978.
Wow.
Yeah.
You've been doing this almost as long as I've been born. I was born in 1972. So awesome. Thank you.
Yes. And I've done all kinds of, I've chaired a county right to life. I've done all the political stuff, but right now in Sarasota, I've done Operation Rescue, if you
okay.
know anything about that.
Okay, for like
about
the animals?
8 years.
Okay.
Just that we blocked the entrance so we could save some lives and no babies would be killed on a particular day.
Amen.
So it was the right thing to do at that time.
Right.
And we don't have that option today.
That's right.
The church hasn't really gotten behind that concept of higher law. God's law is
That's right.
higher than any human
right.
political law.
Amen. Amen. And what is your name?
Carol.
Carol?
Christmas Carol.
Christmas Carol. Amen, Miss Carol.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for taking the time
welcome.
To do this. This is important. But if you don't mind, when you think about a child that God has used you to help save, how does that make you feel?
A partner with Christ, an ambassador for Him. I probably will get to know them in heaven.
Amen, amen, amen. What about that mother, despite of, they see your signs and you're out here and you're reaching out to them and everything like that, but they still go forward with it. So how would you embrace that mother that say, you know what, I did it maybe ignorantly, or I feel bad now? As a born again believer, as you said, you're a believer in Jesus Christ, and so am I, obviously. How do we console those who didn't adhere to what you're doing out here?
Well, I can't do it all.
Okay.
I'm no longer young as they would see a real connection. But right around beyond the parking lot there,
okay.
we have a crisis pregnancy.
Ah, that's
we
awesome.
We take people over there. They have free ultrasound. It's a beautiful place.
Right.
They support girls for long periods of time. We have others that point them toward easy adoption options, and they stick with mothers women who have aborted, and they have
yes.
classes for their forgiveness.
Okay. I can follow up on that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go for it.
Okay, yeah, what's your name, ma'am?
Margaret.
Miss Margaret, and where are you from?
I'm from Venice.
Okay, yeah. No, I'm talking about what organization?
Oh, sidewalk counselors. Well,
okay.
Sidewalk counselors.
Okay.
Anyway, what I want to tell you, we have two programs that we give information to the young girls if we can get to them while we're walking along. One is called Project Rachel. and that is a program from the Diocese of Venice where the girl can go away on a retreat for a weekend.
Right.
She gets to name the baby, she gets to be counseled and to receive forgiveness. And,
right.
And she comes out of that program healed, and some of the counselors here are actually women who have gone through that program.
Wow.
The other thing is they can go online to support after abortion.
It's can you say it slowly so he'll make sure that it's on the video?
Sure. It's called supportafterabortion.com.
Okay, thank you.
They go online, and again, it's another organization for healing. So, you know, the moms are, they're mentored with, you know, a cooperating counselor. And they're walked through the process of healing and come back to holiness and to the Lord and to know that, you know, their little one is with God and, they, and you know, it's not the end. And they then in turn become very active with trying to dissuade other young, you know, women from making that decision.
Right.
So anyway, I just thought I heard you ask that question.
Good. No, that's good. See, hey, we're stronger together, right?
Right.
Oh,
right.
My gosh. And I hope you're aware of what actually is happening here. The nation has 17% minorities.
Okay.
36% of the abortions are done on minorities.
Wow.
If you watch here, I've been a counselor here for about 11 years, and Carol has seen it too. I would say at least half the young women going in here are Black or Hispanic.
Wow.
And it's a genocide that's going on, and we try to get this information out. A lot of your Black pastors are resistant to our message because and we understand it. The compassion goes to the woman in despair or distress. We don't know how the pregnancy took place, and we're not judging, but we understand the whole dynamic. But what they're not seeing is the numbers. The genocide is unreal. It's going on right before our eyes here. And,
wow.
And
that's
profound.
Why Planned Parenthood was established.
Sure, Margaret Sanger.
Margaret Sanger. It was a eugenist.
She was.
And the survival of the fittest, and she didn't see.
Yeah, no, she had it in for the Black race big time.
Right.
And the minorities.
Way back. And these people are trying to disassociate themselves now from Margaret Sanger because it's been, with all of this Black Lives Matter and Antifa and such, it's been brought out that Margaret Sanger was a racist. And Sanger is their saint of saints, and now they have tried to disassociate themselves. You know, their PR now doesn't mention anything about Margaret Sanger.
Right.
And it's, it's a critical point here with this whole operation. I go on and on. Believe me, they're charging the girls over $400 for the abortion pills.
Wow.
The pill works with the first one is taken to starve the baby, and then 48 hours later, the second pill is given to them. They take it themselves. That contracts the uterus, and they abort the baby at home.
Wow.
It's a traumatic experience. If you get to see the movie Unplanned.
Right.
Unplanned. You will actually be walked through an actual experience with these girls at home, how it happens. And the other one, of course, is the surgical abortion. They only do it up to 3 months here. But they use the sonogram machine not to show the baby to the mother.
Right.
They use the sonogram machine to determine how large the baby is so they can charge the mom according to the size.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, right. This is reality here. This is reality. You're not going to get the news media to cover it, but that's really what's happening.
Move
here.
In a minute.
Right.
And anyway, so I'm on my way to church.
Okay.
I'm happy to talk to you, and I'm so thrilled to be here. I'm going to see these two handsome guys here. What's going on?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you
all
so
right.
much.
Honey, God bless you.
Thank you so much for your time and your information. God bless you. Yes, will do. So look what you have done today. You're going to have thousands and thousands of people watching, and they're making them aware of what's going on, and the news media, as she said, is not going to show what you all are doing and what's being talked about, or the reality of Planned Parenthood. Because one of the things that she brought up is some of the pastors here are not aware, maybe, or maybe they are, and they're trying to say, okay, because right now the narrative out there in the news is a woman has her choice. But what about the woman that was raped or anything? Okay, I understand that. We live in an evil world, right? But that child, it's not their fault.
Right.
You know, there's so many people who want babies. You know, if you have the child and then give up the baby, that's a choice instead of killing the baby, because a lot of people, they don't understand that's murder.
Right.
People are being put away for many, many years for murder.
That's so, exactly right.
And it's like that child doesn't have an opportunity to defend themselves.
Well, that's it. But not only that, the woman, oftentimes, she never forgives herself.
Right.
She succumbs to killing the child, it's very hard to get past that guilt, and she becomes again a part of it. And I think in her conscience she realizes that, and that's harder to forgive herself of.
Right.
Wow.
So you guys have heard it.
We have help for the women. We have help for the mother, baby. And I would just encourage you to go around to the first building.
Right.
And look at that center and talk with those nurses and the ultrasound also.
Right.
And get a more professional. We even have a doctor who will come out and reverse that pill.
Wow.
If you can do it within 48 hours after they've taken it.
That's awesome.
And it's happened.
That's awesome.
Here, because someone does change their mind.
And see, it's interesting that you say that, and it's encouraging because we have a place called Any Woman Can in San Antonio, Texas, and they do just that. They educate the women, they educate them. They don't say, okay, well, we don't want you not to have the abortion, but we let them know what are the some of the things. And then they do the ultrasound to show them the baby.
Right.
They say, look, this is your child,
right.
You know. And some women, they go through it, but then they're there post after the abortion to let them know, hey, we will walk along.
Anyway.
We love, right,
and
right.
And God loves you.
That's right.
And you can, you know, it's not the unpardonable sin.
Come on, come on.
But I think a lot of pastors, whether they're black or white, are afraid of.
If you move mine,
they know women in their congregations have had abortions.
Right.
And they're afraid of offending or bringing it up.
Right.
And so initially, I think that was some of the reasons pastors didn't address it
right
in any depth.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Well, thank you so much again. We appreciate you. The nation appreciates what you're doing and all the service that you've given to our country so many years.
Well, thank you for yours also and to our Savior.
That's
forget
right.
The country.
Glory to God. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. Ambassadors for Christ.
Yeah.
So thank you. God bless you.
Well, thank you.
But we were actually, so we're standing outside of Planned Parenthood. And your name again, sir?
Dana.
Okay.
You don't mind holding this to me?
Not at all.
All right, there you go.
And so I was in a great conversation with him just about the fact that some of the myths, so to speak, of Planned Parenthood, like in our country, they can make it sound like it's such a great thing. And it can be, right? They have some great resources. But one of the things we were talking about is how they say that, they offer mammograms and all that, and you were saying that they don't necessarily do mammograms at all.
Yeah, now I refer you to somebody who's a little more studied on it
uh-huh.
to know what they do and what they don't do, but
right.
but they are not comprehensive health care.
Right.
I know that.
But and at this facility here, they actually...
Not that many things they do. They refer to people to physicians
right.
when they need medical help.
But when it comes to the abortions, they actually do them here, like
yes.
today, which is Tuesday.
Yes.
They
are doing abortions today.
And so you guys are out here... Why?
Because some women don't even realize there's help for them.
Like mm.
They think they're alone. They may have been abandoned by a guy.
Yeah.
And they have no idea that all the resources we offer are available.
Yeah.
There's homes that they can stay in if
wow.
they need. There is schooling so that they can support their child if they choose to keep it.
Right.
There's medical help through the pregnancy.
Yeah.
One of the OBGYNs, actually two of them, one of them's on the board. He's the chairman of the board of the Sarasota Medical Pregnancy Center. They do cost-free help
right.
for everyone.
Right.
They've got counseling and parenting teaching for men as well as women.
Wow. Right.
And for the women, you know, they have programs where they can earn points to purchase diapers,
wow.
toys for their kids. There's all kinds of training available for them as well.
I think it's awesome
it's
to see you out here as a male.
Yeah.
That's I think. So when we were riding by and I saw you, I said, oh, yeah, we got to stop. And you're ordained clergy too, right?
Yeah, I was ordained as a missionary.
Wow.
I went to Bolivia, right. served for 3.5 years with South America Mission.
Oh, wow.
And did church planning. And I intend to go back.
Yeah, amen. yeah, that's amen. Good stuff, amen. Man. This is good stuff. So how often, like, when you're out here on Tuesday, do you guys see a lot of young ladies coming, or?
Quite a few, yeah. I'd say a busy day might be, a real busy day would be 20.
20?
Yeah, and then an average day would be about 10.
Wow.
Give or take, you know, it's never the same.
So that's a lot of babies a month.
Yeah.
Now, so can you give us a success story? Do you have a success story? A week,
oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Yes, I do. There was a gal, she came here. I saw her coming up, and so I handed her a brochure and said, and she opened up right away, and I could tell God had prepared her heart.
Right.
She had just had a child, you know?
Yeah.
She
wow.
just had a child, and it was too much. She had intended to get more of a permanent birth control situation,
right. uh-huh.
but had not gotten to it yet.
Right, right.
And all of a sudden she's pregnant again.
Yeah.
Mm.
And she was young. Her partner and her were just overwhelmed.
Right. Yeah.
And she was there, but she felt in her heart
mm-hmm.
that it wasn't the best thing to do.
Yeah.
And so she went ahead and went in. And she got in there and she just couldn't go through with it.
Right. Yeah.
And she came back out, gave me her number
yes.
and started conversing. And I so gave me her number so that I could give her more information and,
oh,
and
yeah,
refer
yeah,
her
yeah,
to
yeah.
people that could help. And so she took that information over the course of the next week and she texted me, and I have the text in my phone. I saved it. She said, we decided to keep the baby.
Come on.
Praise the Lord. Come on, man.
That's good See, stuff. Man, that's know, good
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Yes.
Him, man. It's him.
Yes. That's what it's all yes. about, right?
Yes.
Come on, man. God
yes.
is good. God is good.
Yeah, that's
so
awesome.
So you guys heard it. I think that's awesome. Dana, you said something that really stuck with me, and you and I talked about it. You have to know that sometimes in the midst of fear, things can happen. We can do things that we would never think that we would do
Absolutely.
When fear tries to creep in. So you may be out there watching right now. You may be going through a situation, whether it's contemplating abortion, just know that God has not forgotten about you and he will take care of you. He is our sustainer. He's reliable. He keeps his word. Man, his promises are true. So if you need help, go and look for people just like Dana and their team, right, that can help you, because there are resources, like you heard him say, for women that are contemplating abortion. You don't have to give that baby up and or look, let's be plain about it. Commit murder.
Yes.
Right. We don't have to commit murder, because there are resources out there where you can get the help that you need.
And what about even if they have had the abortion?
Oh, yeah. You were telling me. Go ahead.
Yes,
go,
okay.
Share with that with them.
Well, we also have counseling for women that have had abortions without judgment. A lot of people portray us that way. We are not. We love people.
Come on.
We want people
yeah.
to know that there's forgiveness for them. That's up to them whether they receive it or not. But we will support them regardless.
Come on.
And help them. Counseling, encouragement, and help in whatever way we can. And this is professional help as well.
Yeah, I'm gonna share just this. Dana gave me this card. So you can go on the website, it's www.supportafterabortion.com. Again, www.supportafterabortion.com. If you're out there and you need help, go to the website and they'll give you all the information you need about what you can do, even if you consider having an abortion and unfortunately you go through with it. Please don't do that, right? But this is a website, www.supportafterabortion.com. And again, Dana, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it. And all of you guys out there,
bros for real.
Yeah,
Sarasota, baby. Come on, man.
Hey, we'll see you guys next time on the next episode. Bros for real. We love you. Love, love.